sorry?
Oh, I'm sorry, your novel, your selection. What are you reading there?
Oh, no, it's not a novel, it's a script. I'm in a play at Greendale Community College. I'm on my way to rehearsal right now.
Oh, that's interesting. So do you act a lot around here?
Some. Mostly film work, though.
Anything I've ever seen?
No. Just student films and local stuff. I'm not professional yet. I'm just still learning.
That's not to be ashamed of. I mean, they say a play is an excellent place to learn.
Yeah, that's why I auditioned. That was my thinking, too.
Well, you don't think so anymore?
Will be seeing the title of the play?
Live Free or Sing Hard, Die Hard, the musical.
Wow. Yeah.
I mean, well, is it as, you know,
terrible as it sounds? Worse.
Okay. Well, I was gonna say unique, but there we are. So what are you, the lead?
John McClane? No, that went to the guy with the great voice who looks the part but can't act it.
What about your part?
His understudy.
Why don't you just drop out?
I thought I'd stick it out and see if the guy would make, the director would realize his mistake and make me the lead role. But he didn't, and so now I'm stuck with it because I've waited too long to drop out.
Well, look, you know the secret to surviving stage adaptations unnecessarily desecrating American classics? Look, on the next grueling run-through, after you're done, I want you to take off your socks and your shoes, and I want you to walk around on the rug making fists with your toes. Look, I know, it sounds crazy, but trust me.
I've been doing it for 9 years. Do you want to know the worst part? The whole fist with your toes scene in the play is turned into an entire musical number with a papier-mâché foot dancing in the background. This is me. Thanks for the chat.
Yeah, no problem. Hey, don't give away what I said, all right? We'll spend a hot cup of coffee in the shower.
I think I'll stick to my usual. Doing it for 11 days.
See you around.
Last one. It can't break.
Don't tell me. Tell Marcy Walker. She's the one that keeps dropping them and blaming me.
Excuse me, Damien? But how is this my fault?
Because the microphones were in your hand before they hit the ground.
If you had listened to me before and put a safety strap on the bottom, we wouldn't have this problem.
A safety strap? Like a Wiimote? Marcy, you're going to have to learn how to hold a microphone if you're going to sing on stage.
Damien, I've told you a million times. I will not answer to anything else but Marcy Walker. How do you expect casting agencies to take me seriously if lowly techies won't?
Okay, that's it. James is the director of this play. Therefore, he's in charge. James, do we have to apply a safety strap so Marcy Walker's tremor doesn't destroy our last microphone?
Hannah, just give Marcy whatever... See Walker whatever she wants, so she quits breaking our equipment.
Fine.
You go, girl.
I'll do it.
You should be nicer to the techies. Actors are nothing without techies.
Who's that? Christie, the stage manager. She's a bitch. Did you get over him already?
He's so cute. He looks like Jacob Ben Israel from Glee.
I don't know who that is, but I would be really good on Glee.
Alex, I understand your range, but you're playing John McClane. Can you just please try to butch it up a bit?
I don't do butch.
I know Alex doesn't do butch, But I need John McClane to be Butch. So can you be an actor and just pretend for me?
You're saying I'm not an actor.
No.
Bitch, I'm going to win an Oscar someday. And when I do, I'm not going to thank you in my moving acceptance speech.
We're not doubting you. We obviously cast you in this part. We believe in you. Now give us the performance that we know is inside you and let's put on a spectacular show.
I know what you're doing and I don't respond well to that manipulative motivational bullshit. The only times I've seen The Blind Side? Zero. Because I refuse to cry in front of Sandra Bullock. So if you don't respect me, then maybe you should find another lead.
Alex, please don't do this.
Don't, Alex, please don't do this. Me. I'm the calm one. You're all upset. I can't work in this environment. I'm going to go back to my dressing room. Call me when you all start talking sense again. Alex!
Great. Now what are we going to do?
I told you. I have a solution for this.
James, that's not a solution. That's crazy. And wrong.
But it'll work. And I don't see any other choice. Can I count on you?
Fine. But when this goes terribly wrong, I'm pinning this all on you.
Why? But it will work. Trust me. I know what I'm doing.
That's what you said last time.
Hey, James.
Oh, hey, Owen.
Thanks for showing up, man. I really appreciate your dedication, even though you're just an understudy.
No problem. Hey, speaking of which, since your star seems to be being a little, difficult, do you need me to fill in?
You know what? That would actually be terrific. Go ahead and get in costume.
Okay.
All right, everyone. We're starting from where we left off. Places.
So funny. Jeez, Alex, I didn't realize anyone else was in here. What are you doing?
I'm getting ready to go on stage.
They're still rehearsing.
Rehearsal doesn't revolve around you, Alex.
I'm the star.
Maybe not for much longer.
And what's that supposed to mean?
Nothing. Just, if you keep acting like this, no one's gonna blame them for replacing you.
Replace me? With who? You? Please, boy, you must be dreaming if you can fill this role. Look at yourself. You don't look like a hero.
Yeah? Well, you don't act like one. Let's face it, Alex, this is a play. Acting is occasionally required.
All right, everyone. Now remember, this is the emotional scene, reunion scene between John and Holly. Marcy Walker, are you ready?
An actor is always ready.
Owen, how you feeling?
A little rusty, but let's give it a go.
Well, remember what you can. All right, everybody, from the top.
Holly?
John?
Holly!
Oh, John McClane! Oh. What happened, John? Are we safe?
Finally, we are.
But what about that bad foreigner, Hans Gruber?
Oh. Let's just say he didn't die softly.
Oh. John, you're hurt. Look at your feet.
I'm okay. As long as you're safe, I'm okay.
Well, let's get you bandaged up and home in bed.
Yippee-ki-yay.
Now, I don't remember that scene from the movie.
Who is that?
And what are they doing with my boot?
Hannah, is that Damien?
No, he's still backstage.
Creepy. Alex?
What, bitch?
Seriously, who is that?
I can assure you that who I am is the least of your worries.
Whoa, who is the creepy disembodied voice?
That's what we're trying to figure out.
My name's to clearly mean that so we can move forward is Franz Falcon. I'm taking over this first.
Wait, you're holding us up?
You could say that, Owen Kline.
How do you know my name?
I know much more than merely your name, Owen Kline. Age 20, high 5'9", birthplace Harrisville, Michigan. Parents marrying Cloudline. Two siblings, Damien and Chris. Parents divorced in May 2001. Brother Chris was killed in an automobile accident in December 2000 due to...
That's enough, you made your point! Do you have files like that on all of us?
Yeah.
Yes, Alice Flaire, we do. However, I do not have the time to go into it. I'm here to procure something very specific. Until I did it, you could all consider yourselves hostages.
You in what army?
I don't need an army, Marcy Walker. I have my assistant Deitre and his high-powered assault rifle.
Whoa!
Deitre thinks he's German, which, while entirely untrue, makes him extremely volatile and deathly loyal. Prime henchman zero.
You're not gonna do this. I'm not gonna lie. You're not gonna fire a high-powered assault rifle in a community college theater. No, I think we'll keep rehearsing, and I'll call security.
Fine, have it your way. Deitre!
You son of a bitch! What do you want?
For now, you. You can take your ski off and kick her brain. Does anyone else think I'm not being serious? I didn't think so. My business is in the auditorium. If you stay out of my way, you will stay alive. As soon as Deitre has secured Christie, he will come back and start to fire at anything that moves. It would be in your best interest. Now, go!
Oh my God, I'm for
shopping! Serves you right. You call yourself a man, yet you won't even try to rescue me. You'll rescue me! Owen, you must come back here and rescue me!
Marcy, you're not a child. Get yourself out of here. You are not a star, okay? You were cast as a lead in a misguided community college play. They didn't hire you for your talent. They hired you for the absence of anyone talented who was willing, okay? Your lack of common sense and perspective nearly got us killed out there. And though you don't deserve it, I'm gonna do what I can to ensure that doesn't happen again.
Where are you going?
I'm gonna go find Hannah and Alex and make sure they're okay.
Can I come?
Can I stop you?
Absolutely not.
Come on, then.
I'm gonna have to take my leg, I just know it.
Alex, calm down. We don't even know how bad it is yet. Let's just take a seat, and I can take a look at it, okay? Pull up your pant leg and take a look.
Okay. Don't wrinkle the jeans though. They're new. Guys.
All right, where is it?
Oh, my calf.
How bad is it? It feels real bad. Ow, stop.
Alex, are you sure you were hit? There's no wound, just a little red mark.
Don't patronize me, bitch. I know when I'm hurt.
Alex, I'm serious. There's no wound. Are you sure you were hit?
Well, you're not a nurse, so I'm holding out for a second opinion.
I'm a nursing student.
Well, you clearly haven't taken this class yet.
And what class would that be?
gang wars and terrorist takeovers? You're right. I must have missed that one. But I know what a gunshot wound looks like. And you don't have one, bitch.
It must have grazed me or something. I know I got hit by something. You're a nurse. Why don't you put a splint on it?
Okay, so you're just gonna ignore everything I just said. Whatever. There you go. Good as new.
Ow! Thanks, bitch. What are you doing? Take off your shoes.
These are Prada.
I don't care. Do you want them to get you killed?
Okay, we're good.
So, what's the plan?
Plan now? Find the others, make sure they're okay, and then come up with a plan together.
I have a vocal class after rehearsal. Do you think we're gonna get out on time?
Class? Who gives a shit about class?
It is important that I maintain my singing voice. So, are you gonna call for help on your walkie-talkie?
Yes. As long as we're all together and accounted for, I will.
You know, it was pretty brave of you to go get it.
That's probably the nicest thing I've ever heard you say.
Really damn stupid, but brave.
It's a fine line.
So, how do you expect to find the others?
Ow! Thanks, bitch.
All right, is everyone okay?
No.
He dropped me.
Alex, are you okay?
Well, I was shot in the leg, but Super Nurse fixed me right up.
There was no blood, or bullet hole.
Ah. Well, the important thing is that we're all alive. Now we just have to figure out how to stay alive.
That evil voice guy said that if we just stay out of his way, we'd be fine.
And you believe him?
Why not?
Because he's killed at least one person that we know of. Do you honestly think he's going to leave us around as loose ends?
Exactly. None of this makes sense anyway.
What do you mean?
Come on, do you not find it the least bit ironic that we get held hostage in the middle of a run-through of Die Hard? No, something else is going on here.
And we need to figure out what that is if we're going to stay alive.
Hold on. Who put you two in charge?
Alex, what are you talking about?
You guys are strutting around, making plans, and giving us orders. I want to know why you think you should be in charge and not me.
And me.
And you.
Okay, I don't care who's in charge. I just want to make sure that we're safe. All of us.
I'm with you, Owen.
Me too.
Marcy Walker, you lost your damn mind.
He yelled at me all strong and manly like. I'm a self-respecting feminist woman, but there are some things that men are just better suited for, like leading rebellions.
Okay, well, I'm gonna call for help on the walkie-talkie. Hopefully I can get the security guard and he'll know what to do. Whew. Hello? Is anyone there? Over.
Copy, I read you. Who is this? Over.
My name's Owen Kline. I'm one of the actors in the play.
You're understudy.
Someone is taking the play hostage. They've shot and killed the director and wounded a couple more. This is not a joke. Do you copy? Over.
Copy, Owen. Are you okay?
Yes. Me and a couple others have taken refuge.
Roger, Owen. Did you say someone was shooting people in the auditorium?
Yeah. Did you not hear the gunshots?
Well, I heard something, but I just assumed it was part of the production. It's a very noisy play, you know.
Yeah, I'm aware. But what's happening now is real. I have four survivors here, one wounded, awaiting instructions and help. Over.
You're doing the right thing alerting me, Owen. We'll get the authorities right on it.
Thank you. What was your name?
Carl. My name is Carl. I'm calling the police now.
Thank you, Carl. How long until they get here?
I'm going to get you help as soon as I can, Owen. Where did you say you and your friends were hiding out?
I didn't.
Well, I'm going to need that information if you want me to help you.
Owen.
We have to understand my hesitation, Carl. The terrorists could be listening, too.
trust me.
What's your 20?
My office.
Are you sitting at your desk?
Yes, I am, Owen.
Your Greendale Community College mug, is it sitting on the desk or is it in the drawer?
It's sitting on the desk. Why?
Because, Deitre, the real Carl's mug is a picture of his family.
You idiot! Go and find them. It's time we start gathering up the rest of the cast.
Yes, boss.
I'm sorry, guys. I think we're on our own.
We're with you, Owen. What's the plan?
A gun. The security guard had a gun. It's in his desk. I saw it.
Do you think it's still there?
We have to pray that it is. We're no match for that machine gun wielding German without it.
And then?
And then we fight.
Is anyone in here?
Who is that?
Damien?
No. I'm Damien. Who are you?
I'm Beth. Marcy Walker's friend?
You know, you don't have to say her whole name when she's not here.
Sorry. What are you doing in here?
What does it look like I'm doing?
A seance?
No, I'm hiding.
Me too. I mean, I've been walking around looking for people, but I can't find anyone. Do you think that they're all dead?
No, they're probably just hiding too. Why don't you come on over here? We can hide together.
Okay.
So, what do you do for fun?
I don't know. Shopping, watch movies, whatever Marcy wants to do.
It sounds kind of boring following her around all the time.
Well, we've been friends since second grade, so I'm kind of used to it.
I don't know anybody can get used to that.
She's not so bad once you get to know her.
I do know her, and it's not really fair the way she treats people, especially you. You're way too pretty to be your laptop.
You think I'm pretty?
Yeah, of course I do. I wouldn't let just anybody into my fort.
I think you're really cute, too. I mean, I have for a while.
Oh, thank you. So, maybe it was the fates that brought you into the prop room tonight.
Do you think that everyone will be okay?
I don't think we should think about that.
What should we think about?
This.
Alright, just to go over one more time, here's the plan. Alex, Marcy, find Beth and Damien, make sure they're okay, then make your way up to the catwalk. Hannah and I will go to the guard's office and try to get the gun, assuming it's still in the desk. And then we'll all reconvene at the catwalk.
But what do we do then?
We take back our theater.
So you do know they're going to cause, like, a huge ruckus and draw a lot of attention to themselves, right?
Yep.
Do they know you're using them as bait?
No.
I guess that's the best for all of us. I'm assuming you have a plan to keep us inconspicuous?
I do, but you're not going to like it.
Oh, damn it.
It's fun to see the side of Owen. I mean, he's pretty cute when he's all fired up, don't you think?
He is rather unspectacular.
He's no Paul Walker, do I have to say? I mean, if you were needed to. But you can admit that you wouldn't hit that if he came onto you.
Owen doesn't swing this way.
Maybe I should hit on him. It would be good for his self-esteem. Not that it would last, of course, because I'm moving to California to become a...
For play. Be an understudy. We'll have a couple laughs.
Did you hear that?
What?
It sounded like Marcy.
Please don't think about Marcy Walker while we make out.
She sounded scared.
Oh, listen, beautiful. It's either me or Marcy. Which one do you want?
She'll live.
done these two snooping around.
Good. It's time we start gathering everyone again for the big finale.
Okay, Mr. Falcon.
Who's this guy?
You look German.
How did you find us?
I heard zoo noises.
We have to rescue them.
We will. But I want to figure out their plan first. I want to go in as prepared as possible.
What could they possibly want with the theater?
It's fishy. I've got a feeling it's not about the theater at all.
What's it about then?
I'm scared to find out.
What do you want with us, bitch?
Why, Alex Flaire, I would think of all people you would recognize a curtain call.
Curtain call? What do you mean?
What I mean, Marcy Walker, is that this is the end. We are very close to finishing up this little run-through, and I require the entire cast on stage for a curtain call.
Curtain call? Run-through? What are you talking about?
Now, I would hate to ruin it for everyone before the time is up. If I'm not mistaken, we are missing a couple of people, and we need everybody to proceed. Once I have everyone, however, I can assure you that everything will be illuminated.
Excellent. Now, Deitre, herd all of our guests to their places and find the others.
Yarp.
Owen, what's wrong?
I know him. Franz, I met him on the bus today.
What? How is that possible?
It's part of the plan. It had to be. He saw my script. He knew I was in the play. I was part of the plan.
Why would you be a part of the plan?
I don't know, but it can't be a coincidence. He asked me all sorts of questions about the play.
Owen, this doesn't make any sense. Why is this your fault?
Why today? Out of all days this could have happened, it happened today when I met him on the bus. I must have given him what he did.
What did you say?
It can't be coincidence.
Where are you going?
Going to finish this.
I'm coming with you.
No. Whatever they're planning, they need all of us. You stay here. Watch over our people. Peter can't find you here.
Owen, I'm not letting you go down there alone.
I won't be alone. I'll be the angel watching over me.
What are you doing, Owen? This is insane. You're gonna get yourself killed. Oh, God. This is crazy. Okay, let's do this.
Oh,
Owen Kline, we meet again.
What's this all about, Franz? Robbery?
Nothing so juvenile, no.
Why'd you have to hold up the whole theater, Franz?
It will all be explained in due time. Now take a seat.
I don't think so. I'm here to finish this.
Oh, how noble of you, cowboy. If you don't mind me asking, how do you plan on doing that?
I got a plan.
Oh, really? Does your plan involve this? Deitre?
Hands on your head!
I'm sorry, Owen. I don't know how he found me.
No talking. Get your hands off her! What are you going to do about it?
Down, Deitre. Calm down. Let her go.
You said Deitre could have fun. Deitre has had no fun. It is time for Deitre to have fun.
Deitre, let her go. You're getting out of hand. You're getting out of character. You're losing control.
Hey, what happened to your accent?
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm the potion master, Mr. Potter. I'll dig your heart out with a spoon. I will marry Maid Marian if it's the last thing I do. No. I am the international terrorist Franz Falcon. Yes. Yes!
Oh no!
What do you mean it wasn't real?
Would you like to explain yourself, please? Or would you like me to? Okay, fine. James hired terrorists to hold the play hostage.
Shh, I didn't hire terrorists. I hired actors to be terrorists. I thought that maybe if the cast was held hostage, their performance would be more informed, or at least realistic.
That's insane!
Yeah, things got a little out of hand.
Out of hand? Okay, James, I shot the director of a community college play with a handgun that I stole out of a security guard's desk. We passed out of hand a long-ass time ago.
I'm sorry, Owen. I told James this was a bad idea.
I'll admit, things didn't go quite as planned.
James, you have a bullet hole in your shoulder. Nothing went as planned.
Yeah, well, just to be safe, next time I'll make sure no one has access to a gun with live bullets.
James, no. I'm putting my foot down. This can't happen again. You won't survive.
I'll be
No, you won't. Do you remember that show where you tried to do Jurassic Park as a Christmas special?
Jurassic Park? What about it?
You almost lost your hand to a bad Komodo dragon bite because you wanted to use real dragons.
Yeah?
And then what happened?
The Komodo dragons escaped, still wearing their tiny Santa hats, started hunting children at the elementary school across the street.
That's right. And you promised me then that this would never happen again.
Well, that never did. Besides, I lost my exotic reptile license.
But it didn't end there, did it, James?
No.
Remind me, what was the name of that show where you thought it'd be a good idea to chronicle the life of Satan set to Justin Bieber music?
Justin Beelzebub.
And what went wrong in that production?
I accidentally set a gay man on fire.
Which the LGBT community did not take kindly to.
It was kind of ironic, though.
James, I'm laying out a pattern here so you can finally see that this kind of thing can never happen again. Ever. Do you understand?
Never again?
Thank you. I hope that helps a little, Owen.
Well, I'll certainly sleep better.
No, Owen. Things got a little crazy out there. But you are incredible, man. You want it, the part is still yours.
Consider that my resignation.
Probably a good career move.
You two look like trash, by the way.
Yeah, this death makeup isn't flattering on anyone. Well, I'm gonna ride with Stupid here to the hospital. Catch you later, Owen.
See ya.
Fake blood's mixing with the real blood. Sure.
Stop at Ross and get me a new one.
Yeah, your director over there hired us off Craigslist.
And you had no idea we thought it was real the whole time?
Absolutely no idea. We had no clue, guys. I mean, we just thought you guys were phenomenal actors.
Yeah.
I mean, look, if we would have known, we're really sorry.
It's not your fault. I mean, you guys played your parts well.
Thanks, man.
We're gonna take off. It's nice meeting you guys. Maybe we can work together again sometime.
Sounds good, dude.
Yeah, take care.
Hey, do you think Scooby-Doo and the gang ever actually found real ghosts?
So, Alex, now that we found out that the only thing they were shooting at us were airsoft bullets, can I get my hair tied back, please?
Whatever, bitch. I told you I got hit by something.
Okay, so you ready?
Yeah, Damien?
Let's go.
Wait, where are you all going?
We're going to dinner.
Well, can I come?
It's kind of a double date, couples only.
Alex, let's go tonight. You can be my date.
Look, please. It's been a scary enough day without having a date with you. I'm gonna go home and take a long shower and watch Barefoot Contessa. Bye, everybody.
Bye, Alex.
Well, now what am I supposed to do?
Well, Dieter's been giving me the eye ever since we found out his name was Dave and he works at Jimmy John's.
What do I look like to you? Desperate? He's not even famous.
Not our problem. Come on, girl.
Sorry, Marcy. Call you later.
Bye.
It's Marcy Walker!
Hi. I'm Marcy Walker.